This is definitely not the video I thought I was going to be filming today. You and I till the end, don't need to pretend. Today I discovered that my accounts have been compromised and I am currently out about $25,000. I'm going to do a story time with you guys because I shared a little bit over on TikTok and a lot of you guys wanted to know what happened, how it happened, how I figured it out. So I'm going to be telling you guys everything while opening up this fidget box from Walmart because I want to distract myself. I spent a lot of time crying today. So I'm gonna open these up, play with them with you guys, and tell you how I figured out somebody compromised my accounts. So I use Square, which is a way that people can pay the entrance fee here at Grandma's Playroom. And when they pay the entrance fee, I swipe their credit card, that money goes into my Square account, and then that Square money goes into my bank account. Or at least that's how it should go. However, somebody got a hold of my Square account and switched the bank account to their bank account, which basically means all of the money that I have been making has not been going into my account, has been going into their account. And I discovered it today because my first customer came in. I tried to log on to my Square and I discovered that the password had been changed, which is very weird because I certainly did not change the password. Ooh, this is nice. But I did it. It wasn't me. So I spent a lot of time trying to figure out how to get back into my account. I contacted customer service. It is a Saturday. They weren't open for me to talk to them on the phone. So I had to talk to them on like a chat. I got back into my account and then I looked at my bank account, my personal bank account that's separate from Square. So it's just like where I go to the bank. And I had realized that no money has been put in my account since April 12th, which means for the past month and a half, I have had no income. How did I not realize this? How did I not notice this? I own a small business. I do most of my day-to-day accounting. I pretty much do everything here by myself. And I just completely missed that no money has been going into my account. And I feel like such an idiot. Like, why didn't I catch this sooner? So to all my small business friends, check your accounts, check them often. But guys, the story gets worse. So I realized about over $9,000 should have gone into my bank account and it didn't. It has been going into a different bank account. I did discover that it was a Wells Fargo bank account, which I definitely don't have a Wells Fargo bank account. So I'm hoping that I can get that money back, but I have no idea at this point. They are closed until Monday, so I'm gonna have to call on Monday to see if I can get any of that back. That is a lot of money to be out. But again, it gets worse. I also was on Square and I realized that they opened a business loan, or they like signed up for a business loan. Since I had a certain amount of money come through my account last year, it was like automatically approved because they knew like the account was good for it. So this person took out a $14,000 loan and there was about $2,000 worth of fees. So that's another $16,000 that's just gone. So the $14,000 was already put into their bank account and they've been paying that loan back. So at least they pay their loans back. So I don't have words for this. Like, I'm so heartbroken and I'm so upset and I'm upset at myself that I didn't notice. And I have a lot of emotions right now. I spent a lot of the morning crying. So yeah, let me backtrack a little bit. The first guest comes in, I can't check them in. So I have them sign the waiver. I have them go in, I have them start playing. And I figure out while people are in my playroom what happened, that I have no access. And I just lost it. I am a very emotional person, and when I'm stressed or when I'm frustrated, that emotion is usually sadness and I start crying. So here I am, a business owner, in the middle of my playroom, just sobbing because I realized that about $10,000 should be in my account and it's not. And I don't know how these people who are already playing are gonna pay, and I just tell them, don't worry about it, you don't have to pay, just stay. And they insist. We end up doing a PayPal, and then I open up my Venmo for the day. I post on Facebook that all my credit card machines are down, so I can only do cash, Venmo, or PayPal. Another person comes in and they didn't have cash, they didn't have Venmo, they didn't have PayPal, they only had a credit card. So then I start crying again because, again, my emotions are just all over the place. They end up going to an ATM and coming back. Every single guest that has been here today has been so incredible. Nobody has gotten upset with me. They've all been very worried about how often I've been crying. So yes, I contact Square and I send them a message asking, like, can we freeze all my accounts? What's happening? They can't even verify who I am. And I don't understand why. Ugh, it's a Rubik's Cube. I mean, as if my day wasn't already bad enough. We don't need that. So I contact Square, they freeze all of my accounts. Everything is taken care of so nobody can take more money from me. But I'm still out the rest of that money and I have no idea if I'll get it back, how I'll get it back. And it's very, very sad because as a small business, every dollar counts. So $25,000 is heartbreaking. It's devastating. I mean, I feel like I'm just repeating the same words over and over again, but it's really hard to put in words how upsetting this really is. Like, I work so hard on my small business that it's just devastating when people steal. So, where do we go from here? On Monday, I'm gonna have to call, talk to somebody, figure out how I got defrauded, if I can get my money back, hopefully get it all back. And then I have to figure out how to keep myself safe in the future. How do I keep this from happening? I unfortunately don't have very many answers right now. I'm still learning. I've only owned this business for about 2 years. It'll actually be 2 years on July 1st. So I'm just learning and growing and sharing. I've had a couple of people ask why I'm making content. One, I'm a content creator. Everything that happens in my day-to-day life, I share with you guys, the good, the bad, the ugly. Two, this is how I make money. So if I can recoup any of those costs by creating content, I feel like I should. And three, so hopefully other small business owners who are following me don't have the same thing happen to them. Keep an eye on your accounts. Checking daily seems like a lot, but do it. Check daily. You don't wanna look at your account a month down the road and realize that $9, $10, $11, $12, $25,000 is gone. I mean, it's devastating. I will keep you guys updated on what is going on. Ooh, look at these colors. Opening this fidget box has definitely made me feel better. I didn't really get to show you guys too much of it, but I just wanted to let you know what was going on and share my story with you guys. So that is how I discovered today that I am out currently $25,000. I have had a couple people ask how they can help, if they can donate, and I don't need anybody to donate. The only things that you guys can do to help is watch my content. That is so supportive as a content creator. It's something free you guys can do. Just watch, like, subscribe. I know everybody always says that, but truly, honestly, with my two businesses, the Playroom and content creating, they feed into each other. So it is very, very helpful. And just support small businesses in your area. Support small businesses online, support small businesses locally. I am not the first and I am not the last small business that is going to be compromised. So supporting small businesses is a huge, why is this so greasy? This is like really great. Oh, and this just fell off. Oh, this is like the greasiest pea pod I have ever felt. Oh, I do not like this. But supporting small businesses is something you can do. Even if it's not my small business, a small business in your community can always use support. And by the way, if you were wondering, this fidget box, it's called the Deluxe Fidget Fun from Walmart. It's got 24 pieces. It was like $20. The worst thing was the Rubik's Cube. The slime was really good. The color changing ball is a slime ball, which is awesome. And it even comes with this huge water timer. So this is a great box. If you've got a local Walmart, run and go get it. And yeah. So I don't want to say if you guys like this video, because hopefully none of you guys like this. But if you enjoy these story time sit down chats, I would appreciate it if you gave this a thumbs up. And if you loved it, I'd love it if you would subscribe. I hope you guys have a wonderful, wonderful day. And don't forget, check your bank accounts and wash your hands. Bye, guys. You and I till the end.